So the last video that we're doing is setting up an SSH host on our local machine, and it's really simple. So let's go ahead and open up Terminal. We need to install Openssh server, so go ahead and run sudo apt-get install openssh-server, I believe it is. We'll get an error message if that's not it. It's been a while since I did this, so. So now, once we have it installed, you're basically good to go. However, we are going to make it a little more secure. We're going to change the port that this runs on, and so there is an sshd config file now. Let's go ahead and run sudo nano. It's in /ssh/sshd_config, I believe it is. There it is. So we can go ahead and make this more secure by changing the port and also changing the authentication stuff. So let's go ahead and change the port to 2212 instead of the default 22. And then we're going to scroll down here a bit. And under authentication here, we're going to change permit root login to no. So nobody's going to be able to log in as root. We're going to scroll down a bit here as well. And we're going to add a line that says allow users. And this is going to take basically a list of usernames of users who are allowed to log in through SSH. So I'm going to make my user account able to log in through SSH, and this is going to restrict all other users from connecting to this machine via SSH. So I'm going to save it and exit. I'm going to clear this a bit. And then what we need to do is restart the SSH service. So run sudo systemctl restart SSH. And you're good to go. And so now if I were on a different machine here, actually, let's see if I can get my external IP address here. I don't think I can get it through here. No. All right, let's clear this. Gonna open up network-tools. I'm gonna do something like, if you guys have seen the movie Inception, this concept that I'm about to do will feel a little bit familiar to you. This, by the way, when you go to network-tools.com, the IP address that pops into this input field by default is your external, your public-facing IP address. This is the IP address that your internet service provider gives to you. Now, actually, in order for this to work, this would have to be the only machine, or I would have to set up through the router DMOS port forwarding or a host forwarding. But what we can try, we're going to try it anyway. I'm going to SSH into my pointy bracket server. And then from here, I'm going to SSH into this machine. If it'll let me, it probably won't forward that port. So I would have to go through my router at this point to configure port forwarding for that port 2212 in order to be able to connect from an external host to this host. If you only have one machine plug, so basically, like the IP address of my server, when I go to the IP address, it goes directly to my server. It's not configured through NAT addresses. My server actually has 5 IP addresses, and those IP addresses go directly to my server, and that's why I can access SSH on that server without having to configure any routers or anything. I think actually the server provider managed that in some way. So anyway, you know, if I were to go into my router and configure DMOS or port forwarding, what I was just doing would in fact work. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys again soon.